Anthony Albanese has dismissed calls for an inquiry as bullying claims surrounding the late Senator Kimberley Kitching intensify. Ms Kitching's best friend says she was scared of the Labor leader and was a physical wreck before she died of a suspected heart attack.
A Labor leader in damage control, fronting up to the cameras for his first press conference since Wednesday after allegations of bullying in his team.
Politics can be a robust business.
Admitting,
we can always do better.
But dismissing calls for an inquiry, despite claims by late Labor Senator Kimberley Kitching's best friend about the final days of her life. Health Workers Union Secretary Diana Asmar telling News Corp Kimberley was a physical wreck leading up to her death and says she has no doubt that the workplace bullying Kimberley endured by her Labor colleagues significantly worsened her health.
I received no complaints about the treatment of Senator Kitching from Kimberley at any time.
The three female senators accused of mistreating her, Penny Wong, Christina Keneally and Katie Gallagher, have denied the claims, with many senior colleagues saying now is not the time for inquiries so soon after her death.
Labor people overwhelmingly are just giving support to each other at what is a difficult time.
I think we owe it to each other in the Labor family and to the nation more broadly to get around each other at this really difficult time.
But the government says Labor owes it to Kimberley and her family to investigate and criticised the Labor leader for an apparent attempt to avoid questioning today.
He went to the Central Coast, an hour from Sydney, and gave the media 45 minutes to get to a press conference. Come on, Mr Albanese, if you want to be an alternate leader, you've got to be up front more than that.
Weeks out from an election being called, this will be a testing issue for Labor, and the Liberals will want to keep it in the spotlight. But the Morrison government has a challenge of its own in the South Australian election tonight.
Scott Morrison faces losing a key ally in Liberal Premier Stephen Marshall, and the possibility of that would leave the National Cabinet table with just two state and territory Liberal leaders compared to Labor's six. But it's the federal election that will test both sides.
I've swung towards Labor over the last probably decade.
I've always just been a Liberal voter.
Rachel Baxter, Nine News.